Hello, my friend. Welcome to day number one of the declutter challenge. I am so excited for you to embark on this decluttering journey. As I mentioned in the welcome video, it is a very unique declutter challenge because we're not just focusing on your spices. In fact, we're not actually touching your spices at all. We're not just diving headfirst into your junk drawer because there's so much more to uncover before we actually dive into your physical clutter. So today is about your beliefs, and I'm just gonna pull up the worksheet that hopefully you have also printed out as well. So today is day one. We are focusing on the mind, a limiting habit or belief that is holding you back from reaching your goals up until now. So today's prompt says, what is one habit or belief that you've been wanting to stop, but you haven't yet, that's been holding you back? Is it sleeping in? Is it eating bad foods? Is it staying up late? Is it procrastination? Is it buying too much stuff? Is it fear? Is it feeling unworthy? So, a limiting habit could be buying things constantly from the dollar store, even though you want to reduce the amount of clutter in your home. It's easy to buy, it's very cheap, and doesn't cost very much. So, it doesn't necessarily reflect on your bank statements constantly, but it will reflect in your space because you will accumulate stuff a lot. So a bad habit is constantly buying cheap items, bringing them into your house, or maybe you're even getting these items for free or off of like a $1 auction site, which I know exists on Facebook. You're bringing it into your home because you think it's a sweet deal, but if it's taking away your time, which means it's also taking away your peace, your space, then it's actually not a deal at all. It's actually costing you way more than you think. So, a limiting habit that you might have is accumulating stuff that's cheap or free or easy to get and then just bringing it into your space. Another limiting habit that you might have is late night snacking. If one of your goals is to lose weight or sleeping in, if one of your goals is to start getting more stuff done in your day, maybe a belief that you have that's been holding you back is your fear. You might just be f afraid to fail, afraid to be judged or to be seen or to look silly after trying something and it may not working right away. A belief might be money is hard to come by. A belief might be that you're too hard to handle. A belief might be nothing comes easy. A belief might be you're just unlucky or you have bad luck. All of these things are ruining and running your life. Maybe not necessarily ruining your life, but it's definitely running your life. Your habits, your beliefs, your thoughts, the things that you think and say to yourself, and then you create actions on them, and then your continuous actions become habits. So everything starts in your mind. What you believe to be true about yourself or the world and the environment around you becomes your truth. And then anything that you think, you will then behave on, and then anything that you can continuously behave on then becomes a habit formed. And so what you have to do is you have to reverse engineer it. You have to assess your habit. You have to understand why you're doing it. You have to look at all of the ways and the reasons why it's been created, what it has given you up until now, and then change that habit, and then also then change your thoughts and beliefs around that and create a better thought process for yourself. So if you are, let's say you're sleeping in and you've created a habit out of this, pressing snooze every day. I can say this because that's what I was doing as well. So every day I was like, oh, just one more day of pressing snooze, just one more day of sleeping in. One day led to months and months and months, and eventually it was like a year of pressing snooze and sleeping until like 7:30. And then I came up with all of these excuses why I was late every day and not getting my work done and not being able to maintain my responsibilities to the status that I wanted them to. It was a reason why I was choosing different things because every morning I was pressing snooze and that was setting my day up for failure. Now I had to go back and ask myself, what am I getting from this? What am I gaining? And why do I have so much resistance a bit around waking up earlier or not pressing snooze? Or why do I have so much comfort over staying in bed later or, having control over being able to press snooze one more time, one more time? What is that giving me? And what would I like instead? Who do I want to become, or who must I become in in order to get the results in my life that I desire to have. And so everything in your life revolves around your thoughts, your habits, your beliefs about yourself, your beliefs about other people, your beliefs about stuff, your beliefs about the world around you. What are your beliefs? And it's shaped from when you're young and you adopt things and you pick them up. So for this exercise, you're only going to choose one habit or one belief or one of each. And you're just going to say, you know what? What is one habit that is not serving me right now? And how can I change it? And then what is one belief? Maybe it's wrapped up within that habit. What is one belief that is holding me back from becoming the best version of myself and from getting the results that I want, which, you know, it could be in any area, because this challenge isn't just about decluttering your physical space. It's about decluttering all of the areas in your life that you feel are cluttered and disorganized and not up to the standards that you want to live by. And so it's up to you to create it, to reframe your beliefs and recreate your habits. And so in the space below, that's where you can write it on the worksheet that you have printed out. And then you can go ahead in the Facebook group and share your experience, share the habit or the belief that you are committed to changing. So I hope that today's challenge isn't too difficult for you. I hope that it gives you something to think about. There's so many resources and books and audiobooks and podcasts all around this. But just starting here on this day one of the decluttering challenge is the best place to begin. So make sure that you go into the Facebook group, write on the accountability post for today, and I will see you tomorrow. Bye.